Okay, everybody. Welcome to part number 28 of me driving from Key West, Florida to Anchorage, Alaska. Today we continue heading northbound on SK-39 as well as SK-6 that joined along with us last part at the end. So, here, see, I don't even start part 28 till like 10 till 9. Right now it's 9 minutes to 9 o'clock already. So, we gotta cross the train track again. Gotta go to SK-6 North. Okay, now folks, we're going to continue going straight on. I don't know which way I'm going because. Well, I have to. So I don't know how long I've been on this K6 for. Might have to take a look at my GPS and. Might have to check my GPS and. Maybe it should tell me which way do I have to go. Should I keep going on SK-6 North or turn left onto SK-39 North? It'll be on. Okay, so I gotta be on SK-6 North about 'Gotta be on Trans Canada Highway SK-1. We're going. It keeps me on to the West Virginia bypass. Then after that, I'm going to have to go on to SK11 North. And I got to be on it for about 146 miles. See, we're filming. Yep, we're still filming. Yep, the GPS tells me I gotta continue on SK6 North. Till I turn onto the Trans Canada Highway. I gotta continue on for about almost 21 miles, so I gotta take the Trans Canada Highway 1. Gotta keep track of my. I gotta keep track of my road so I can. Oh, look at these mobile homes. That mobile home was cute. Was cute and pretty. That house is beautiful. Those Canada homes are beautiful. And to be quite honest, we had to be truthful for that, because I just want to keep track of the GPS route there so I don't have to get lost there, because I don't know what will happen if I get lost. I might get. Oh my god, because that would be absolutely terrifying there. When we get to the Yukon part. When we get to the Yukon part in Canada, to Yukon, Canada, it's gonna be a crazy ride. You heard me. It's gonna be a crazy ride toward Yukon, Canada. And I gotta be on that highway for about almost 1,000 miles. You heard me. 1,000 miles. I gotta be on it for like almost 1,000 miles. You know how crazy that is. That's a crazy number. I'm telling you, that's a crazy number. Well, and besides the fact, here is the problem with my own video there, because Oh, when we get to the Yukon Canada part, it's gonna be. Cause I'm way, way all the way up in the north. I'm all the way in the northwest. Oh, look at that garage. That garage is awesome. Let me see. Oh, guess we're about to head on. Oh! Are you serious? They closed? Oh, sorry. Gonna have to try. Oh, look, I can't get on. There's no other way I can get there. Cause I'm totally thinking that this highway is completely, cause I'm thinking this highway is completely closed. The westbound side and getting on the Trans Canada Highway 1 is officially closed down. I don't know how we're gonna get on. May have to cut the video for a little bit until I we'll have to figure this problem out. You know what, guys? There's just no way. We're just not gonna sit at this road over here anymore because I'm gonna go ahead and take Ring Road there. I'm gonna have to go ahead and take Ring Road all the way to Trans Canada Highway 1 there instead of going just Trans Canada Highway 1 because it just somehow does not let me on there because of this stupid route not going in the right way. I was like, it lets me go in the wrong way direction. That don't make any sense afterwards. I'm seriously telling you guys, that don't make any sense afterwards. I don't know why they still take it as a considered a wrong way direction. I seriously do not believe Canada. I don't believe that stupid Canada made me go in a stupid wrong way path. How would they make that up? I'm gonna have to take Ring Road instead there. If there's another way. If there was a way to get there. I should probably take. Should probably take this one there. I don't know if it was a real one, but it was a fake one. But it's a fake one. Let's see if this is the real one. As for a matter of fact, let's try that. Let's try that one. Hopefully this don't give me a problem. Hopefully it shouldn't be a problem. Come on. Please tell me it's the real one. Yeah, here we are. Taking the detour. We're on Ring Road right now, because this kind of like almost looks like interstate there, because I unfortunately have to take Ring Road there because this GPS wants me to turn around, and this GPS wants me to turn back around and go to the other way, because it wants me on Trans Canada Highway 1, which is closed down. That's why I had to take another way to get the Trans Canada Highway 1 better. Hopefully it should not be a problem, because it wants me on there. Like about a few miles back. Which is closed down. Then after that, I gotta be on SK-11 North. This is sus. Saskatchewan's Highway of Heroes. Like Saskatchewan's. This is Saskatchewan's Canada. Cause I think that's what the state name is. I'm pretty much bad at the Canada part, but USA is better. I know, but USA is better. They shut down this road too. We're in Saskatchewan's Highway of Heroes. Now here we are on the Trans Canada Highway. This is what we should have got on earlier. Right until it was completely shut down. Well, here we are on Trans Canada Highway 1. And this lane is only a 2-lane because of that. See how long I've been filming for. Oh great, we've been filming for like only 32 minutes there. I know it's 25 minutes after 9 o'clock on this Monday, April 20th, 2020. Well, excuse me. Thanks. Excuse me again. Thanks. What's the speed limit? We're gonna. The speed limit? Yeah, 110 miles per hour. Am I not there? I think there was a mobile home over there. It's right by Trans Canada Highway 1. I should be pretty good in this filming right now. It's about 23 minutes to 10 o'clock on Monday, April 10th, 2000. No, Monday, April 20th, 2020. It's not the 10th, so. Excuse me again. Wait, what the? Well, what the? Is that a? Don't tell me there's a tornado there. Don't tell me I spotted a tornado. Well, I don't want to see a tornado in Canada. That would be dangerous. Oh no, if it lands on the ground, well, hope it doesn't, hopefully it doesn't touch the. Other than this, hope it don't touch. It's gonna be life-threatening. It's gonna be a severe life-threatening in Canada. Since I had to take an exit to SK2 South, no. Oh my, this. Oh boy, I think there's gonna be a tornado on the ground there. Oh boy, it's gonna hit the ground. Oh no, no, it's hitting the ground. It's gonna hit the ground. Oh no, 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 it's hitting that ground. Please be okay. Oh my god. Go with the speed on this road. Yeah, the highest speed was like 110 miles per hour. Now it's at 100 miles per hour. Where is it at? Well, we won't be able to take SK2 north there. We gotta look for SK11 North. Well, that's not the one. All right. I wonder if we just passed it, because I'm not. I gotta. Luckily, there's no tornado coming at us, thank goodness. Well, we're gonna have to end part 28 right here, folks. So on Trans Canada Highway 1, thank you all for watching. Leave a like, comment, and subscribe. Don't forget to click on the notification bell for all the latest content. I'll see you all tomorrow for part 29. So don't forget, tomorrow, my filming starts between 7:30 p.m. or 8 p.m. tomorrow. I'll see you tomorrow night.